This video is sponsored by Squarespace. Hey everyone, what's going on? Welcome back to a new YouTube video. Today we are going to be talking about portfolios, and specifically for photography. That's obviously what I know best, but this can really apply to anybody who has an artistic career or considers themselves an artist. You want to have a great place on the internet to display your work, and a portfolio is, in my opinion, extremely necessary to get the kind of work that you want to be getting. Now, I'm going to show you guys my portfolio in this video, kind of break it down why I've done certain things a certain way, and also just give you guys some tips and tricks that I've learned over the years to kind of dial in your portfolio and make it as clear and concise and good looking as possible. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So before you even get started with your portfolio, you're going to need to make image selects, obviously. Now, this can be the most daunting and difficult process when it comes to making a portfolio, but I firmly believe that it's probably one of the most important parts. It really kind of defines your photography aesthetic, and it also sets the ground for what could be a great or a not so great portfolio. And I really think that the difference between those two often comes in how and why you select certain images. So I typically go through my shoots on kind of like a monthly basis and just kind of scrub through them and see if there's any images that really kind of stand out to me that I could add to my portfolio. It kind of gives me a bird's eye view over the last 4 weeks of shoots. And sometimes that's quite a bit of shoots. Sometimes it's only a couple, sometimes it's none. But I think, you know, regularly looking at your work and kind of like categorizing it and understanding that, you know, it could potentially live on your website, and it also maybe just gets thrown on social media or sent to friends and family. There's a big difference, in my opinion, between all those different things, and we're going to kind of chat about that today. I think a good rule of thumb when you are adding images specifically to your portfolio is for every image that you put up, you should take one down. And I've kind of like abided by this rule for the last couple of years, and it's worked really well for me. But you want to keep your portfolio really concise. And I think the more that you can take images down that don't suit your personal style anymore or the direction that you want to head as an artist, this is going to be really helpful. If you're finding that you don't have enough images that you're proud of to put into a portfolio, or you don't have enough images on your website, just get back out there and shoot. There's nothing to be ashamed of. It's just something that we all need to work towards on a pretty regular basis, and it's something that I personally work towards all the time. And I really think that it's very important to just get out there and shoot regularly and shoot the kind of stuff that is aligning with the style that your portfolio suggests. So first and foremost, less is always more with a portfolio. I think in the beginning, I used to add just kind of every one of my favorite images from every shoot onto my website. And I kind of noticed that I had a lot of like similar images or duplicate images. And I took a lot down and kind of just restarted from scratch, which I highly recommend doing. And I just really picked my absolute favorite images. You guys will see on my photography portfolio, my homepage, it has about 30 to 40 images. And I've found that that kind of works really well for me. I like to keep things concise and to the point, and this works really well. So I've definitely found that the more selective that I am with my images, the more impactful my website actually becomes, because there's not as many images. The images that are up there are ones that I'm really proud of. They're images that I've thought about a lot putting on my website. And I've finally, you know, put them as a collection with other images that also make sense. And they just define who I am as an artist. And I would definitely recommend that you guys kind of continually audit your website and take down images and just make things much more concise and to the point. You're going to really thank yourself for that in the long run. So I think a great way to do this when you're looking at if images should be on your website or not is just to ask yourself, does this image represent who I am as an artist or as a photographer? It can be really difficult to kind of evaluate your own work, especially when emotions and memories are attached to these images. But at the end of the day, you really need to kind of separate yourself emotionally from these images and really just place the ones on your website that really make the most sense to represent who you are as an artist and as a human being. So another thing that I've definitely found really helpful over the years is to really put the images up on your website that you potentially see yourself getting hired for. And this potentially could just be work that you've shot on your own. It could be personal work. It could be actually paid work. But at the end of the day, you want prospective clients to see these images and want to hire you for those images, if that makes sense. So a lot of the time you might have to create work that you want to be getting hired for, and that's perfectly normal. A lot of people do that, including myself. A lot of the work over on my website is just work that I've shot on my own, because I know that the more that I do that, the more clients might be interested in hiring me for that kind of work. Now, for me, I stick to a couple different things on my website, usually something along the lines of automotive, portraits, lifestyle, and also some architecture and interior photography. And for me, these are the kind of main categories that I like to stick to, and definitely the categories that I'm interested in getting hired for down the road. So that's really what I mainly put on my website. You won't necessarily find any sort of weddings or paid portraits on my website. That isn't stuff that I necessarily want to be getting hired for in the future. I do shoot weddings still on occasion, but as I said, I'm putting the work on my website that I want to be getting hired for down the line, you know, in the future. And I'm creating the work right now and displaying it on my website because I want to be getting hired for that in the future. future. So I would definitely recommend that you guys do the same. Figure out the genre of photography that you really enjoy or the genres, and make sure that kind of work is up on your website and on full display for potential clients to want to hire you down the road. A great example of this is, say you want to be shooting cars, you know, you love taking photos of cars, you love automotive photography, but when people look at your website, it's mostly weddings. Nobody's gonna be hiring you to shoot automotive photography because there's just a bunch of weddings on your website. So, you know, really tailor your website and tailor your portfolio to exactly what you want to be getting hired for down the road, because that is exactly the direction that clients are going to push you, is based on the work that you have on your website and the work that you're showing to the world. So another incredibly important part about creating a portfolio is going to be organization. Now, I'm gonna show you guys my website right here, which I actually have already up. I just wanna explain to you guys a little bit of how I organize my website and, you know, the steps that I've taken to organize it properly. Okay, so as you can see, when you first land on my website, I mainly have the overview page here. This is like 30 to 40 of my favorite images that I've taken. And I really think that these images really represent me as an artist, especially my new work since moving down to Los Angeles 3 years ago. But I think, you know, these images I'm really proud of. These are the best images, in my opinion, that I have to show. And I regularly update this, but not, I don't take a lot of images down. If anything, it's, you know, just an image here, an image there. But yeah, I think these images itself are really, you know, kind of what define me as a photographer. And I really want to be shooting this kind of work and getting paid for this kind of work. I already do get paid to shoot some stuff that looks like this, but a lot of this is stuff that's just shot on my own time. And I would very much recommend that you guys do this as well. It just, you know, is a great way to really feel like you're making progress with your photography career. Just, you have stuff to show, you know, you have a lot of different kinds of images to show. And I really think this is the best way to go about that. And for me, this is going to be the homepage when you land on my website. And up here you see I have the navigation tabs. Now this is what I mean by organization. I think this is really important. So here I've kind of categorized a lot of my other images, you know, images that might not necessarily make this main homepage, but there's still images that I think would might be beneficial to clients that want to see, you know, stuff that I have to show basically. So here I have the portfolio section, which kind of breaks down stuff by photographic genre or style. Here I have a lifestyle section, a portrait section, landscape, automotive, and interiors. Now, the lifestyle section is probably the most built out of all of these. These are just like tons and tons of different lifestyle images that I've shot over the years. Much more in the moment, much more candid than the rest of my work. And this is something that, you know, a client might want to see if they want to hire me for a lifestyle shoot, for example. So this is what, you know, kind of I do to kind of break down the subject matter that I have. And over here, I also have a commissions page. So this is, you know, kind of all the paid and spec work that I've shot over the years. And it's in a nice, neat, organized kind of folder. And you can click on any of these and you'll be brought right to the page. For example, here's some Lululemon photos that I shot. And pretty proud of these. But yeah, for example, like, you know, maybe you want to see if I've shot something, you know, in the yoga kind of sphere. And these are images that are gonna be perfect for that. Or maybe you wanna see some automotive stuff. Here I have a Toyota Tacoma shoot that I just shot a couple weeks ago. And, you know, so it just kind of gives a wide variety of the different kinds of client work that I've shot. And everything's nice and neat and organized, which is probably the most important part. I also have some travel photos over here, some information about me as a photographer, and then also some video work as well. So this is kind of how I've laid out my website. If you guys want to lay yours out in a similar way, you should definitely use the Squarespace template that I've used. And I think, honestly, this is a great opportunity to talk about today's sponsor, which is Squarespace. As you guys know, Squarespace has been a huge sponsor of this channel for so long, and I really appreciate all the things that they've done for me as an artist. But when it comes to specifically with a portfolio, you know, I've used this Squarespace website for such a long time, and I'm actually really, really happy with how the design and layout the entire website, you know, the UI. It's really easy to click through multiple different images and, you know, everything just looks nice and neat and organized. I myself love nice big images, and, you know, this really kind of helps with that. This theme, I think, is called Wexley, which is one of my favorites. And, you know, as you can see, I have like an information page here. It makes things nice and easy and organized. You can email me right from here. And yeah, I'm just really happy with Squarespace as a platform and also obviously as a sponsor. I can't thank them enough. If you guys want to check out Squarespace, I will leave a link down below as always, squarespace.com/SamuelElkins to get 10% off your first website or domain purchase. As I said, I can't recommend them enough. I've used Squarespace for many, many years, and I probably will be using them for many years to come. So moving on to the last couple pieces of advice that I have when you're making a portfolio, I think a really great option once you have your portfolio all the way set up is to seek outside opinions. Now, this isn't just from everybody, you know, you don't just want to put your website up on your Instagram account and just have everybody, you know, have free reign over the comment section. I more mean that you should reach out to people who you respect as an artist and have them check out your work and really kind of offer a unique perspective, because you kind of, you look at your work and you kind of get like tunnel vision a little bit. You kind of just forget that, you know, you definitely can improve. That sounds condescending, but it's not. You know, you really just look at so many of your images day in and day out, and you don't kind of realize where you could add images to make your work seem more well-rounded. And I think this is a great opportunity to get that outside perspective, that outside opinion, because it really does help and matter. I myself have a couple of friends who I really kind of trust photographically and as an artist, and I really respect their opinion. And I'll send my website over to them a couple times a year just to kind of get an opinion and see where I can improve as an artist. You know, I think this is something that has really benefited me, and I would definitely recommend that you guys do that as well. So in closing, I just want to thank you guys for watching, obviously, but if you have any questions about creating a website or, you know, maintaining a photography portfolio, I'd be happy to respond to some questions down below. I think, you know, as long as you just kind of stick to the key values that I kind of talked about in this video, it's going to be a lot easier to make your portfolio. I kind of wish I knew a lot of these things when I first started out, but you know, making a really nice, clean photography website is pretty difficult, and it takes time, it takes effort, it takes years and years and years of taking photos. And I think the more that you can really just, you know, hone in on what you really love shooting and really kind of convey that on your website and make it really organized and personable, you're really going to start to get hired a lot more, because you have a clear vision, you have a clear aesthetic, and you're not afraid to do things differently than anybody else. So hopefully that kind of shed some light on making a portfolio. As always, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this one, and we'll see you next week. Peace.